I don't wanna be afraid every time I face the waves. I don't wanna be afraid.
What? What'd you say?
I don't wanna be afraid.
What'd you talk about?
So we're here with the Cajun Army, and this is a man's house that has been affected by the hurricane and how the flood has just destroyed everything in his house. Ceilings are coming down. There's mold. The floors are, they have all wood framing, and so the floors are all tipping and the house is basically falling apart. They have them one by's just bracing some stuff up in here in the kitchen area. The smell is quite atrocious with the mold and mildew everywhere. I'm not sure if there's power here or not. Just taking you for a quick walkthrough of the house and of the mold and in the rooms of how it's falling apart. Wow, yeah, water was high, very high in here. So we're gonna be tearing out all of the drywall and the things that, everything right down to the frame, and see what there is left to work with. There's ceiling fans and there's, and here's Dan. Hi Dan, how are you?
How are you? Assessing
our project. So we're starting on this end of the house and gonna just start with tearing off the doors. You can see the water level that was in this house is, well, if you look here, Dan,
2 feet.
About 2 feet. Yeah, if you stand next to it, it's up past your knee. So
18 inches.
It is quite the. Oh, here's a masked lady ready to work. Very nice. Another one. Hello, how are you? Thank you for coming and serving. All right, well, for now, that's the end of my video. Thank you very much.
Because I hear it roar. I don't want to fear the storm. I don't want to fear the storm.
Hi, my name is Dorley Dahlke. My husband's name is Joe. We attend The Well in Tomahawk, Wisconsin. And we were on the trip to Louisiana with the Cajun Army, with Jess and Brandon and the Novitskis and multiple other people. And so today I'm just going to share a little bit of a testimonial with you. As a Christian churchgoer sitting in a comfort zone sometimes, I was afraid to step out and travel and do anything like that, mission field wise. And I realized that once you step out of the comfort zone the first time, it's just that first time getting over it, you will never not want to serve when the opportunity presents itself. And one of the things that that I really saw in this trip in particular was just a group of people. We didn't know each other. Most of us did not know each other. And we were thrown into a minivan for X amount, how many hours of driving? A lot of hours of driving. And we all got to know each other really well, got along really well. And I think the message that I took out of one of the takeaways from that is we were all there with one purpose, to serve God, do it to the best of our abilities, and not pay attention to our comforts or likes and dislikes of the things that were happening around us, or, you know, people, a lot of different personalities and perspectives, but it didn't even matter. None of that mattered. We were just there to serve. So this was a really just a special trip for my husband and I. And I encourage people to, you know, give it prayer and thought, and the next time an opportunity arises, definitely step forward. even for those, sometimes people think I have too many like physical or whatever emotional issues. I don't think I could serve, but you'll be used in some way. And most of the time when you do go serve, you find that you thought you were there to serve, but really you come out of it realizing that you're so blessed and that people that you serve just in return serve you in a special way, and God will use you and use them. It's always a win-win situation. So I highly encourage any one of you sitting there watching this video to really give it some prayer and thought the next time we go to Louisiana or wherever Cajun Army is going next. So thanks for letting me share.
Hey everybody in Stanley, my name is Gary Metter. I'm a member of the Northwoods Vineyard Church in Tomahawk, and this October I had the opportunity to go with a team that included some folks from your church as well as the Well Church here in Tomahawk to Louisiana. We worked with the Cajun Army down there doing some demo work for two awesome people who had gone through the hurricane down there this last year. Two very different circumstances for these folks, two different situations entirely family-wise, but we really saw the Spirit move. We saw the Holy Spirit just doing His work down there and allowing ourselves to be Jesus down there to those people. The Bible does talk about going out and telling the world, and that was a big part of the mission, was just going down there and being Jesus to these people. And just these disasters, just seeing the effects of it on them, just putting a smile on their face. Who knows when the last time they were able to put a smile on their face, but we saw that. What an incredible opportunity that the Lord laid out for us, allowing us to go down there, and the blessing we were able to be to those folks as well, being able to hand out some money to them and just be a blessing in that way as well. And blessing us along the way as well. There was a lot there for us personally. Each of us just had a different experience. The Spirit fell on each of us in different ways. You know, the Bible does talk about disasters and how those things just, unfortunately, are just part of our world. But still, the mission doesn't change. We are Jesus to these people. And that is the biggest part of it. And to me, being in accounting as I am, the financial aspect, I mean, when you see the figures of that, people were telling us, you know, when we're done with all the work for the day and we go and discuss it at the end of each day, off by ourselves, that we're saving these people $30,000-$40,000 in demo costs. That is just overwhelming, because these are people who probably don't really have a lot, and all they have is their homes, all they have is their families. But that's enough for them. You can really see that. But just remember that when you have the opportunity to go and be Jesus to people. And it can come in any way, in any form. Just don't miss that opportunity. Move as the Spirit moves. Do what the Spirit does. And blessings will go far and wide. So thank you for letting me share this. I really appreciate it. Blessings to all of you.
I'm not gonna be afraid. These waves are only waves. I'm not gonna be afraid. No, I'm not gonna be afraid. And I'm not gonna fear the storm. You are greater than its roar. Oh, I'm not gonna fear the storm. No, I'm not gonna fear it all. Peace be still. See, till I'm dancing in the deep.
Hi, my name is Jess Cato. Hey, just want to thank you for this opportunity to share about our Louisiana trip. So this year, this was my second time going. It looked a little different for me because about a week or two before we left, I actually found out that I was pregnant with our fourth child, which was super exciting, but kind of messed with my plans a little bit, which God has a way of doing that. And so when I first found out, I was like, oh man, do I even go? Like, I can't go into moldy houses and all this. But I really felt like God was saying, like, oh no, you're going. Your assignment's just going to look different. So I trusted him and I obeyed and I went. And yeah, it was a long trip, 17 hours one way in the van. And in fact, actually it took us a little longer, ran into just some accidents and stuff like that. But we eventually got there. It was probably closer to 20 hours. Man, the 3 days that we spent though working were incredible. The team did a fascinating job working together as a team. Almost everybody going on this trip, you guys, were strangers, and yet we had a common goal of just going and helping, and everyone just pulled together, which is so cool. So that really blessed me to see that. But then for me personally, I got a really cool opportunity to work on the campus that we were staying at, and I got to know this really awesome lady who also was with the Cajun Army but had been getting over some kind of sickness, so she wasn't able to be on the job site. So her and I hung out. I got to know their pastor down there and just made some really cool connections that we've continued to just have in our lives. And in fact, it was pretty tragic. Our friend Pastor Tim, his wife actually passed away, I think, like, oh, it was Thanksgiving Day. And so terrible tragedy, totally unexpected, but it was so cool. As a team, we were able to stay in touch and pray for him and just be another connection in the body. So I'm really grateful for those connections. And I think what I'd like to say just about missions in general and just about the kingdom of God is that it doesn't matter who you are, where you've been, what you've done, what you haven't done, what you think your talents may or may not be, God has specific things that he is calling you to. And sometimes we're trying to just figure that out. And sometimes it's, you know, him just pushing us to try different things. And for me, a mission trip is a great opportunity to step out and just serve and see what God does. Because, you know, a lot of times they're centered around just helping. Well, they are. They're all centered around helping people. But there's always different jobs. There's always different needs. And, you know, I had to really realize, too, that part of my calling was to sit with the family and just chat with them and love on them, and that blessed them and it really blessed me. So yeah, I just really want to encourage all of you just to be the hands and feet of Jesus and just to go where he's calling you to go and do the things he's calling you to do, even if you're like freaking out and like, I can't do that, or you know, I don't know if I'll even, you know, be good at that, God. I mean, it's really not even about us. So take some relief in that, and just know that being obedient is the highest praise we can give God. And so anyway, I hope this encourages you and blesses you, and just passing on our love from Tomahawk. All right, love you guys.
My name is Brandon Cato. For me, this trip was just going down and helping our fellow Americans. It was just kind of the patriotic thing to do in my eyes. You know, Louisiana got hit with three hurricanes in the last couple of years. Because we, Jess and I went down to Lake Charles, you know, the previous year, or in 2020, I think it was. And then, again, you know, down in the Hammond area was where we were, staying at Camp Living Waters. I can't express it enough. I can't tell you enough. If you haven't done something like this before, I encourage you strongly to step out of your comfort zone, travel half across the country, crammed in a van full of people you don't know, and you will have the time of your life. And you know why you will? Because you're going down with not only your fellow believers in Christ, but you're going down with people with the same goal and the same mission and the same heart to touch somebody's life. To help out by saying, hey, you know what? We're not in this for us. we're not, we didn't come down here to make money. We didn't come down here to vacation. We came down here to gut your home and be here for you, to help you, because we love Jesus and we want you to know that Jesus loves you.
Let faith